up-and-coming band of quality vintage, you have come to the right place. The Headbangers Ball is on location in Karlsruhe, Germany, the hometown of these guys, Pink Cream 69. Here they are. How are you doing, guys?
Fine. Great. Thanks.
Now, you guys have been on a club tour all over Germany, and you've also played some of the festivals. How's it been going for you?
Well,
it's been going good.
It's been going really good. We were really scared to death, to put it honestly. The first show we played, well, all the shows we actually played in quite small clubs from what we were used to playing. But we thought it would be better if we hadn't played in a year and 4 months. And so we all were going on stage ready to shit our pants, basically. Because it was like starting all over again. Nobody had a clue what's it going to sound like. What do we do? Is our set good? Is it bad? We changed it 10 times. I think we changed it while we were playing, too. It turned out quite good for what we expected. People came, people were happy, and had a good resonance from the crowd. And then we played at the festival, the Rock Am Ring.
Is that the biggest show you've ever played?
Yeah. So far the biggest show, yeah. That was,
it was a nice experience, playing in front of 25,000 people.
Yeah.
It was really...
That was cool, though.
I was really scared to death,
to be honest.
Now, we're in Karlsruhe tonight, which, as I said, is your hometown, and this makes it an extra special gig, really, doesn't it? Is it kind of more nerve-wracking that it's home territory, or is it kind of more fun that you've got friends and family coming down tonight?
I think mainly the biggest problem is to arrange the guest list.
We talk a little bit about the new album, Games People Play, and you co-produced that album for the first time, as a band. Does that kind of indicate a new degree of confidence between the four of you?
Hopefully.
I think you can consider it that, but I think it was simply that we were really, really prepared for this LP. We made demos, some songs I think we recorded in 4-track, Walkman, 8-track, ended up 4 or 5 times, and we went in the studio pretty sure we knew what we wanted to do, you know. And so it was actually quite easy. When we worked with Dirk together, we told him what we thought, and he told us what he thought, and we sort of compromised stuff together. We were basically there from beginning to end studio time. There's no real vacationing going on this 4 months we were doing it. We were also there during the mix and everything, so we had a big part of it this time.
Well, what has happened to you guys since the last album, One Size Fits All? Because for Games People Play, it seems that the happy-go-lucky kind of lyrics of old have kind of almost disappeared, and that you've gone for a much more serious outlook. Now, is that just you growing up as people, or what has been happening to you to make you feel like that?
I would say that's one part of it. Yeah. And the other part is just doing this profession for a few years and traveling around and seeing good things and bad things, and that's just all the themes on the record are not just like what we could write about a deep theme or whatever. It's just like discussions being going on in the nightliner, in the rehearsing room, just things we like and we don't like. Mm-hmm. Just really things, themes which we've been talking about, not just like searching for a theme or whatever, you know.
I think it's sorry.
I was just going to say, a lot of it seems quite pessimistic.
Is it? Yeah. It shouldn't sound like that. I just wanted to say that the time changed too, you know. I mean, the time when we started up with Pink Cream 69, I think it was something so-called a sunny time, you know. Everybody has got his money and everybody's got his jobs and no troubles around, nothing to see. But I think nowadays it's too much shit going on, you know. So I think it would be a big mistake as a band to pray the good times when there are just no good times anymore, you know. I mean, too much troubles is going around, and I think we all feel responsible to say something.
What do I see? A bunch of hateful people talking to me, the crap they
they say it's been hurt before, and that's what started the Second World War. So many people.
About the first single, Keep Your Eye on the Twisted, did you feel it was important to confront your country's past as well as the present in that song?
It's not only about our country, especially Germany. We are three nationalities in the band. We've got a Greek drummer, got an American bass player, and two boring Germans. I think as a multi-international band, you have to say something about this theme. And everybody's looking at Germany, and everybody thinks, well, the Nazism is coming from Germany again. But we, as a three nationalities band, we think that it's not only a German problem. You know, I think if everybody's held in each the hand of each other, so I mean the countries, we could go against this Nazism and fascism shit. You know, but meanwhile, I think it's just going the other way around. The fascism's, they organize themselves and they are yelling the loudest, and this just cannot be the way it should be, you know.
When I saw you on stage in Stockholm with Europe at the beginning of last year, then your stage show very much reflected that kind of happy-go-lucky outlook. Has the kind of live show had to change for the new songs at all?
I don't think so. I think the happy-go-lucky thing on stage is basically like we could write complete songs about death, destruction, and total depression, but we go on stage, we're so excited, the song could be like, I want to kill you all, I'm happy, you know, it doesn't matter, you know.
I mean, also, the audience is coming to a gig and they want to have a good time, you know, and they don't want to get depressed, so I think...
This would be the wrong way. I think problems are there. I mean, everybody can see them, but I think when you take them in a commercial way, then everybody's listening to it. But if you say, look, it's everything is shit what you're seeing, then I don't think everybody's looking. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. So you think that you can make a difference by using certain subjects in your music to draw attention to things?
Oh, I think we can. But I think the stage is the wrong place for it, you know. People come to a concert to have fun. Mm-hmm. And I think the lyrics are basically for the moment where you sit down at home with your headphones on.
Right.
And just think about it and listen to the singer. What is he saying? What is he trying to tell me? You know, just think about
anyway.
And we're not going like everything is shit and forget it. We're just talking about things we don't like, and not all of them are pessimistic. You know, there are still a few positive lyrics. We kept them to be not too depressive.
Talk a little bit about the new single Face in the Mirror, which is an interesting song about drugs, really. Was that how was that song inspired? Was it first-hand experience or?
Yeah, it's a little story about a girl we met in a really cheap hotel. We've been in Hamburg a couple years ago. We met her in the TV room. Guess you can see how cheap the hotel was. And she's been staring about 1 meter down of the TV, and we didn't check it out in the first moment. We'd just been sitting there and watching TV and having fun together, and we looked to her. Later on we started to talk with her, and about half an hour later she came up with her needle and her stuff and everything, and then that's been the moment when we left, And the most depressing thing for us was she kept talking. She's been doing that for 7 years. That's what she told us. And she said, I can stop whenever I want to. Problem A. And problem B was the most inspiring thing for the lyrics was that you saw that the girl's been very beautiful once, you know. And we, in the song, Facing the Mirror, we tried to describe the process of how the drug is destroying your body, you know. My opinion is that this is the harder songs are harder and the softer songs are softer than some of them we've ever done, you know.
There's more dynamic, more contrast.
We said this before, and I still believe it. You know, we make songs, and we just try to pick the best songs. You know, and if all those songs would be speed metal songs and they were great, I wouldn't care. You know, if they were all ballads and they were all great, I wouldn't care. it doesn't. We don't go into the practice room. We need to get heavier. We need to get softer. We go. We need songs. We need good songs. We need to make an LP that someone is to listen to. And that's it.